It's difficult for me to talk about some of the in real life things. I would much rather create a episode. Oh, this is the drive show, Vernon and Howl episode 6, probably, or some kind of episode number. If you're listening to it right now, you know, because you're probably looking at a blog post or a title that says the number, so you know if it's 6 or not. I'll check later. But this doesn't really, I'm not real in a sense that being an anonymous person online who then occasionally uses his outlet for his artistic stuff, which is what I do, when he occasionally when that stretches over into the world of wanting to talk about things that are going on in my real human life, it's not an easy thing to do. Yesterday I had a bit of a traumatic experience. I went to the dentist for the first time in, I want to say, 14 years. I'm not exactly even sure. I was in high school, or I was very young the last time I went to the dentist. I'm 31 years old. I don't have dental insurance, but my teeth were getting a little screwy in the back. I had some cavities. Okay, sorry. I had some cavities. They were bad. They were getting bad. One looked bad. I knew there was a couple in general. So I scheduled a dentist appointment because I'm like, hey, screw it. I have some money. I have a little bit of money. How much is this going to cost if I have to get a cavity or a couple cavities filled? I knew there would be several cavities. And I'm thinking, you never know how much it's going to cost. I really didn't know. I looked up a little. It was too stressful to really think about it. I had to decide. I've been meaning to do it for a long time. Set up the appointment and just do it. What can you do? I don't have dental insurance. Dental insurance only, I guess, isn't great anyway for most people. So I figured, you know, spent. Anyway, I'm in no pain, mind you. So did I need to go to the dentist? I don't know. I'm very neurotic. I felt like my worrying about my teeth was adding to my general neuroses in life, which was stressing me out more than I already am. So I just fucking booked the dentist appointment. Anyway, 6 cavities. They filled 2. I got to go back in 2 weeks and get 4 more, which is going to suck. It was a horrible experience, and it drained my bank account to next to nothing. So as I sit here today, all told, I have very little money to my name as it stands right now. Obviously, I have a job. This is where I talk to you on this program. I drive from where I go to work back to my house. In this case, it's 12:58 Eastern Standard, and I'm heading back home for lunch. So, it was a very... I felt disorienting. Is that a word? Disorienting? Disorientating? I felt very disoriented in life after I had to... Because I had always assumed that I don't care about money. And I don't. I'm 31 years old, and right as of now, after being raped by the dentist people, I have basically no money, $100... in my bank account and waiting for the next paycheck, which is a week from this Friday, so it's not even that close in the horizon. And I have no credit card, so I can't put it on there. And plus, not that that fucking matters. I mean, you're still paying the same, right? I mean, so I've tried to get. I'm 31 years old without a single credit card, because I haven't tried. I've tried a couple times, and I guess I have some issues, which is something I don't even want to go into. But I guess. So I've tried to get a few, and I guess every time you don't get one it actually worsens your chances of getting the future, which is... So I hate that whole system. I fucking despise the idea of credit and debt and what that even means, and what that says about humanity in general. I think that it's a bizarre system that puts people in neat little holes and of worth and self-worth, and in a lot of ways I refuse to even engage in it anymore. A couple times, you know, every time I get was trying for a credit card, it was for a reason, I guess, and you know, it's always for, you know, there's always some sort of thing going on, but I was just kind of like, you know, that never bothered me because I was glad almost. So I was like, okay, I don't have to buy into that. And I've given up all hope on, like, home ownership and things like that. I, you know, I'm one of the, obviously, you know, they talk about all the 99%, you know, Wall Street people. And, you know, you can say anything you want about any of that. But the bottom line is that people who live in my kind of socioeconomic range, who make what I make, and have the benefits that I have, being employed to the type of company that I have, that I am, all across the board, have the, you know, fundamentally is the same issue, is that there's really no, you know, the best case scenario is you're not swimming in debt, right? So me, I'm not really swimming in debt. But I live this kind of existence where it's like, well, there's no saving money happening. I still try and do the things I want to. I go on vacations and I buy, you know, if I want to buy a book or something, you know, where, you know, I work within the realm of that, and I, you know, tell myself that there's a happiness to be found there. But man, sometimes, especially when you realize that you aren't in love with this work that you have to go and do every day. And I've always felt like I've been a worker, and I've had jobs since I was 14, consistently steady ever since then. And but that, to have just you know, kind of a little bit unexpected, in a way it could have been much worse. If I needed a root canal or something, which the dentist scared me with for a second, and when he looked at my tooth a little deeper, and he was like, "Oh, you don't really need a root canal at this moment." He was, he was like, "At this moment," and I'm like, "Dude, I have no pain. What do you want?" I mean, you know, but he was almost upset that he wasn't gonna go deeper into my pockets. But I guess that's, you know, that's how some people are, and I don't, whatever. But where am I going with all this talk about stuff? Is that I'm almost using, I want to maybe use this as a and not that I have used the first few episodes of the Drive Time program radio talk show that you're listening to right now. Not that I've have been using it as a platform to talk about myself in this kind of personal way, especially personal ways, but as far as money is concerned. But what I really realized is that if I'm going to continue to do this, or I'm going to continue to use any of the time that I have, I really have to just strip away. I have to just strip away all of that stuff that is the real me, and let the kind of stuff that I'm embracing as the non-real me, so the, if you want to say it, the artistic persona that I've developed, and I think I've done as good a job as I can, and I want to, and I hope to do even a better job. And part of the reason by me talking about this right now is to have that progress even further along as a fully formed thing, but I, you know, you have to strip away this idea of me as a real human person, because it's a fucking nightmare. It's a nightmare of stress, and there's just no winning this game to kind of play by the rules as anyone else. And I'll still do it. There'll be like that zombie side of me that I kind of still walk through this fucking shit that makes no sense to me. because there's just no getting around that at this time. And I'm not the kind of person who's going to just, you know, become a hippie and you know, quit and not have any money and, you know, and put the burden on, you know, other people around me to try and, when ultimately that idea, you know, that whole thing doesn't pan out. But what I can do is just use this time to not think about it. So the idea of worrying about anything, like the stuff that I was talking about, like dentist bills and things like that, they don't exist in terms of, other than the fact that they're just stuff that happens to me. So paying $1,600 dentist bill equals seeing a moth land on a flower.